It's so nice to be with all of you, and I just want to say thank you so much for choosing GCC, and we appreciate it. You are in the hands of some stellar team members, and I'm just excited to have you here with us virtually. Hopefully this pandemic will be over and we'll get to see you in person on campus. For those of you who are returning, I see a lot of returning faces. I see Jackson, I see Evan. I can't call out everybody, but I see lots and lots of great faces and names that I recognize. And Ian, I see Ian, who's also one of our dedicated students. Look at him, he's repping GCC. I love your hat. I just love your hat. Everyone should have a hat like this. Get yourself a hat. we're just delighted to have you here. And what I'm most inspired by is all of you as our college students. You're coming in with fresh ideas, with great lived experiences, with all of your identities, and you make our college who we are, the community that we are. And we love to watch you as you grow, as you develop, as you find yourself, as you find your passion, and as you ultimately go on into the world and make the difference that you were destined to make. So we're delighted to have you here. I see Acadia here. We have lots and lots and lots of people, lots of role models for you. We have peer tutors who are here with you. We have student senators, we have student trustees. I hope that you will become more engaged with the college and that you will find ways to become involved in student activities. If you are not part of a club by the end of the semester, by mid-semester, I hope you consider that. And I also hope that you will take advantage of all the resources that we have available for you. You'll hear more about all of them today. And what I will say to you is that the really smart students, they seek help before they realize that it's too late. So whenever you need help, please know that we are here for you. Nothing excites us more than to see you thrive. So thank you very much. I'm going to hop off, but I'm going to leave you in the able hands of our entire team. And I just want to say, Tamitha, thank you so much. And Dean Barry, and we've got Gary, we've got Dean Matthew here, Dr. Ackerman, Peggy, you know, just the whole team is really extraordinary. So thank you so much. Have a wonderful night and enjoy orientation this evening.
Thanks, Eve. I really appreciate it. All right.
My pleasure. Bye-bye.
Have a good night.
Bye-bye. Good to meet you guys.
Peggy, are you available?
I am.
Yay.
Hi, everyone. My name is Peggy Fallon. I'm a dual enrollment advisor here at Greenfield Community College, here in my guest bedroom, I suppose, in my makeshift office. We're so happy to see you here tonight. I'm usually fielding Google voice calls, but it's been quiet tonight, so I'm actually able to say hi. So glad you're here. I just want to reiterate what Eve just said. Successful students ask for help, even if you don't even know what that question is. So please don't forget, you have instructors that are here to help you. You have your advisor that's here to help you. And you have your students, your peers, the students in your class to help you. So don't hesitate to reach out, please. Have a great semester.
Thanks, Peggy. All right, and now Gary.
Hello, everybody. I am Gary Ackerman. I am the coordinator of instructional technology here at the GCC. And that means that I work with faculty to develop online courses and whatnot. So I might not have a whole lot of direct interaction with students, but I hope my work does reach you through your faculty members. So welcome aboard, everybody. I'm glad you're here.
Thanks, Gary. All right, so now we're going to have the orientation leaders introduce themselves, and we're going to start with Jackson.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jackson. This is my second year, my last semester at GCC, and I'm a chemical engineering major. I was involved in the theater group when we were still actively doing theater, and I'm now a peer tutor as well for math and science. And what I love most about GCC is the endless resources and opportunities. It's not hard to find. If you look, you'll find many great people and you'll surely find something for yourself. So yeah, I just say, yeah, ask questions and look for the resources.
Thanks, Jackson. All right, Acadia.
Hello, I'm Acadia. I'm a criminal justice and dual enrollment student here at GCC. I'm also one of the student senators. One of the things that I really enjoy about GCC is because it's a small college, there are so many people ready to talk to you and instructors are happy to help at any time. And it's really great and something you probably wouldn't get at a much larger college. And my advice for all of the new students is even if you don't think you're going to need the resources that we show you tonight, just check them out. That way you know where they are and you know how to find them and you know what they can offer you.
Thanks, Acadia. All right, and now turning things over to Samantha.
Hi, I'm Samantha. I work as a peer tutor at the college, and I am going into my seventh semester at GCC, so I've been here for a while. And it's been a really great experience. I think that my two pieces of advice to everyone for how to make it a great experience is to get involved. First of all, you're gonna get what you put into it. And second of all, definitely as like Acadia was just saying, take advantage of the resources because there's a lot of support and it is available to you.
Sorry, thanks, Samantha. All right, and now Ian.
Hi, everyone. My name is Ian. This is my third year at GCC and my final year, hopefully. not hopefully and yet hopefully. It is a wonderful place here. I love all the resources and stuff we have on campus and off now that we are doing this whole thing over the internet. I am a criminal justice major. I also work on our Slack peer support channel, which you will hear about more as we move through tonight. I hope you'll all come check it out and, you know, criticize some of the insane things I do, you know, just have some fun conversations. I can't wait to get to know all of you more. Some pieces of advice I would have. I suggest you check your email very, very consistently. I made one mistake in my beginnings to GCC, and I'm pretty sure I now have to tell that story every single orientation. So here goes. I didn't set my email up correctly when I first came to GCC. And by the time I realized my mistake, I was most of the way through the semester. I missed a couple of deadlines. I showed up at school, which won't be a problem now because we're virtual, but on a couple of snow days. And so when I finally got it set up correctly, I had 574 emails, many of which were very important. So, you know, my big piece of advice is that you check your email very consistently. Ask for help. It is not a sign of weakness, whatever you may have heard. I don't know why that theory circulates around so much. And welcome to GCC.
Thank you, Ian. All right. And now I'm going to turn things over to Rafaela.
Hi, I'm Rafaela. I'm an orientation leader. Right now, my major is social sciences, but I might want to switch it next semester. I'm a peer tutor here at GCC for writing and Spanish. And one of my favorite things about GCC here is how flexible and accommodating this college is to helping me to work towards my degree at my own pace. And a piece of advice I have for a new student would be to really, and this is just in keeping with the whole theme of tonight, but really reaching out and asking questions to any department or any faculty member or peer is super helpful. I definitely can sometimes get caught assuming in my head that like the answer is going to be obvious or that there won't be an answer, no one will know. And I've had just the opposite experience where I've had 100% super positive response rate to every question I've ever asked at the school and learned a ton. And I just want to say that I went to a couple colleges before I landed at GCC. And so I think it's a really great environment for students with all different kinds of educational backgrounds.
Great. Thank you, Rafaela. And now our last orientation leader, but definitely not least, is Evan.
Hi, everyone. My name is Evan. I am a liberal arts dual enrollment student. So I'm also a senior over at Northampton High School. I am a student senator, the Senate treasurer, and I'm also helping out with our Slack channel. And one piece of advice is, here at GCC, we are a great community and we all want you to succeed, every single one of us. So reach out if it's through the Slack, through emails, feel free to reach out to us on Student Senate. Everyone wants to help you get to where you wanna go. So please reach out.
Great, thank you, Evan. And now I'm gonna turn things over to Anna.
Hi, everybody. I'm Anna Berry. I'm the Dean of Students at GCC. I've been here for almost 15 years now. I'm not going to tell you how many emails I have in my inbox, but I do check them every day, many times a day. I myself am a community college student. I would have never, ever gone to college if it hadn't have been for community college. And I would have never dreamed that I would be working in a college. I also made a major career change when I came to GCC that completely shifted the way I was headed. So it was really cool to see in the chat the number of people who are talking about coming back to school after having done other things or coming right out of high school. That's the beautiful thing. Our college represents the way the real world looks in that we have all ages, all different backgrounds. So welcome and let's turn our attention to Tamitha. She's got a lot of info to share tonight.
All right, so I'm going to turn off my video and I'm gonna get the presentation started. So everyone else who, if you have your camera on, it's time to turn it off. So a couple of things. The first is that, let's see if I can share my screen and talk at the same time. The answer is not really. I just have to talk myself through what I'm doing. And then I have to wait for the Zoom controls to get out of my way so I can get to the screen I really want. Ooh, this is me trying not to curse out loud. So just so you know, thank God. All right, sorry. First, very important, we are recording this. Don't worry, no videos of viewers are going to show up unless you turn your camera on for some reason. And the reason why we ask for you not to have your camera on is you really need to be able to see this whole screen. So that's there. The other thing I wanted to make sure you know is that this is going to go the full 2 hours. And honestly, if I'm being really clear, based on how the orientations went this fall and how last week's orientation went, we're probably going to be here until at least 8:40. I'm really sorry things are running late. You need to stay until the end because we have a survey at the end, which is really important to us because we get such valuable information from it. And then the other thing that survey does is it's how you get credit for having attended orientation. We will be taking a break about halfway through. It'll be after the advising/career services section. Because I know like 2 hours is a long time to sit and try to pay attention. So first things first, let's talk about what we're gonna talk about. First of all, I do hope you all feel very welcome. We truly are so excited that you are joining us at GCC and we're really happy that you have joined us here for orientation this evening. So then we're going to have a little story about a plant. We're going to talk about why communication is so important. It's always important, but especially while we're remote. Why technology is your friend, especially your friend while we are remote. And then we're going to talk about things related to like starting the semester. We are going to talk a lot about resources. And then there's the survey I told you about. You should definitely plan to take some notes. Honestly, it's the only way I remember anything. That being said, the thing you were supposed to do before we got started with this whole shindig was to download the orientation packet. If you didn't do that, it's okay. You can still go back and download it. But what I wanted to tell you is I'm going to throw a lot of information at you in a relatively short period of time. I don't expect you to remember all of it, but that orientation packet is going to have information that will help you remember the stuff that I've talked about. So like you would do for class, you know, in class you take notes and then you're supposed to review your notes within 24 hours after taking them so that you can help yourself remember the material that you took your notes on, but also to fill in any gaps. So what you really want to do is that within the next 24 hours, make sure you go through that orientation packet and you'll be like, oh yeah, she said that about that. The other thing though that I really want to draw your attention to in the orientation packet is, first there's a letter from me, you can read that or not, but after that is a piece of a document that is a list of quick links. So every office or department that's talked about in this presentation, there is a link to their website, or if there's a specific person you should email, there is a link to that. So that is like, I kind of figure like that's going to be something that you can reference very easily. And so definitely keep your eye on that. All right, let's get this party. Well, it helps to push the right button. So this is Dr. Eve Salomon Fernandez, who you all met. And when she says that she wants to make connections with students, she truly, truly means it. So definitely look for opportunities to connect with her. You know, if there's, you know, if she's leading a cooking demonstration or something like that, I absolutely encourage you to check that out. All right, so let's talk about this plant. So not this past summer, because we were all remote, but the summer before, Peggy came into our office. We are in the same suite, and she's like, Tamitha, you have to check this out. I was taking a student to another office. I took the outside route, and growing out of the stairs was this plant, which I thought was a weed, but then I looked at it, and it's not a weed. It's a tomato. I was like, oh, yes, I have to check that out. And so I went, and there was this adorable tomato growing out of these concrete steps. And of course, I had to take its picture, because how could you not? But also my immediate thought was, there is a metaphor for our students in this. And so a lot of our students overcome a lot of barriers. Everyone overcomes some sort of barriers before they get here. For some students, you know, getting to GCC is like, you know, a really big step for them. And so, so this tomato, you know, represents what you've overcome and what you in the direction you're going in. So this tomato plant, that seed, found that one tiny patch of dirt. And that tiny patch of dirt is GCC. And it put out its roots. So that it was it, the putting out its roots is how it found its resources. And it got what it needed. It got enough nutrients so that it could grow and be and actually bear fruit. And so this is just a reminder that you are tougher than you know. All of us have survived 10 months of a freaking pandemic. So truly, we are tougher than we know. Please take advantage of your resources. We have a lot of them. One of the things I love about GCC is that the staff and faculty and your fellow students really are here to support you and want you to be successful. And then obviously nature is just freaking amazing. And then I just love the idea of tomatoes everywhere. All right, and we're off. All right, so communication. Communication is incredibly important. And we talked about, Ian talked about, and Anna talked about email. So the reason why we cover this stuff early on is because it's so very important and we know your brains have the most capacity to take in this information early on. You need to check your GCC email every day. This is especially important while we're remote because even when we're not remote, your GCC email is the official way that the college communicates with you. So anything that the college needs you to know, it goes to your GCC email account. If your instructors are trying to reach you, it goes to your GCC email. If other folks at the college are trying to reach you, it goes to your GCC email. And so you do want to make sure you're checking it every day so that you don't get, so that like, if you wait a week and then you open it, there's going to be like too much. It's going to be overwhelming. But if you check it every day, you can be like, all right, this applies to me. I need to do something with this. This I don't need to pay as much attention to. And I really stress this because I know how, A, I've been in higher ed for a long time, but also people in general, we know they're not always so fabulous about checking your email, checking their email. And you really need to not do that with GCC. So make sure you check your email. And then I feel like there's something else I wanted to tell you, which is Oh no, I'll get to that later. Okay, so I assume you all know this already, but I'm going over it anyway. To get to your email, you click on this blue login button. Also, while we're here looking at the main GCC webpage, if there's something that you're looking for at GCC, use this search bar. Lots of folks just use that as their go-to to find anything at GCC, so don't be afraid of the search bar. When you click on that login button, it brings this drop-down menu. This is where you can get to your email. It's also how you get to Moodle, which obviously you know because you got there this evening, and how you get to My GCC. We're going to talk more about those in a second. It's also how you can get to the student help desk. You forgot your password, that sort of thing. That's where you submit a help ticket. So those things are in that drop-down menu. The advantage of using that link to get to your GCC email is that it fills in this last part, the @stuemail.gcc.mass.edu, which is awesome because then you don't have to type it. I will mention this. If you have another Gmail account, remember you have to sign out of that before you try to sign into your GCC email. Once you've signed into your GCC email, you can add it to your Gmail accounts. And I mentioned that because I had a couple of students who are like, I can't access my email. And then they're like, oh. And then they log out of their personal email and then they're like, I got it. All right, sorry, here we go. Oh, so speaking about email, you are going to get a weekly email Monday mornings that's called News and Updates for Students. Please read this email. It has information about upcoming events. So even though we are remote, there are still like fun things that we do, like virtual trips to the New England Aquarium, but also if there's like a career services workshop happening or there's, you know, that sort of thing. So events, as you can see, orientation was mentioned in this email that I grabbed. There's also a list of announcements. So if there's deadlines for scholarships or that sort of thing, or if, you know, there's something you need to know about, you know, buying books from the bookstore, like that will be there. This email is a font of information. Make sure you read it. So yes, that's your PSA for the day. We are on social media. We have a general GCC Facebook page. There's a Facebook page for student activities and community service. There's a library Facebook page. Check all of those out. I believe there's also a Facebook group called the GCC Squad, which was created by some students when we all went remote last March. And so, and there's also one for the Alumni Association. I encourage you to check out all of those. We are on Twitter. Please follow our Twitter accounts. And we are on Instagram, so you should follow that as well. All right, technology. We are remote. Technology is our lives. So we're going to spend a little time on technology so you have some basic information so that you can be prepared for classes on Monday. All right, so My GCC, and I'm realizing there's a space between My and GCC, and there should not be. Nobody else has pointed out that typo to me. So My GCC is our student information management system. It's where you go to see your schedule. It's how you can register for classes. You can find your advisor. You can pay your bill. All kinds of stuff are here. Here where it says submit a form, if you click on this button, it'll give you some forms that you can just submit electronically. We're going to talk about a few of those a little bit later. Over here on the left-hand side are where you will find announcements. This GCC alert update, if you haven't checked your information to make sure your alert information is up to date, please make sure you do that. I will tell you, after you update that, this button just stays there forever. Here are, you know, a couple of some GCC announcements and events, but it won't be everything. It'll just be a couple of things. Look, there's orientation from the fall. And then this is the quick links to the quick glance at the academic calendar for the dates that are coming up soonest. If you click here, where if you submit a picture for your ID, you will have a picture. If not, it'll just say no photo. If you click on that, that will bring you to your dashboard. Up here is where your account information is. So you can, you know, double check that your email is correct, your phone number is correct. If you have a preferred name or, you know, your name and you want it to make sure it shows up places, you can change that here under My Account. And that will show up on, you know, rosters and that sort of thing. So definitely check out what's hanging out under My Account, but now we're going to talk about what you would find on your dashboard. So, and when you click on your dashboard, it brings up a, it brings up your schedule. And once you've been here more than one semester, you can look at previous terms as well. It will tell you who your advisor is. You can get to a more detailed version of your schedule here. You can look at your unofficial transcript here. So if you need a copy of your unofficial transcript, you can just get it right here. If you ever forget what your student ID number is, it's hidden under this button that says Show Student ID. Other things that you can find here is information about financial aid, if you have any holds on your account. And then if for some reason you want to revisit your AccuPlacer scores, you can check that out in the testing tab. I think that's pretty much the stuff. So when, here's something important to note. Not that I expect you to remember this. Final grades show up here in my GCC, not in Moodle. Speaking of Moodle, okay, Moodle is our online learning management system. This is where your classes live, okay? And so this, of course, is going to be very important. Since classes start on Monday. When you log into Moodle, it looks something like this. This is your dashboard. You can always get back to this by clicking on the dashboard link to the left. Your courses are here in the center. You can arrange them in different ways. You can have them in list view. This is card view. You can also get to a list of your courses over here on the right-hand side. That's how we got to the orientation today. I think that's most of what I wanted to tell you about the main page. We're going to talk about this GCC links link in a second. When you click on the class, it's going to look something kind of like this. The course, main course information is going to be here in the center. All right, here's something that's two things that are important to know. Your classes, not all of your classes may be visible yet. They become visible when instructors make them visible. They will be there by January 25th, so by Monday. If on Monday one of your classes isn't there, then you'll want to email the instructor. All right, so this is important to know. Instructors set up their Moodle courses differently. So you want to spend some time checking out each course, making sure you understand how your instructor has set up that course. So a lot of instructors set it up weekly, so everything you need to know for this week is here, everything you need to know for this week is here. Other instructors will set things up thematically. So all the homeworks are in one place, all the readings are in one place, all the handouts are in one place. So again, you just need to figure out how your individual instructor set up a course. And then, you know, general course information is at the top. So you'll usually find a syllabus and other things up here. Over here on the right-hand side are quick links to resources that are available to you, such as peer tutoring, the help desk, student help desk is there. Look, information for how to forward your GCC email to your smartphone so you know to check it all the time. So that's what it looks like when you log into a course. All right, so I'm going to talk to you about things that you really, really, really need to do before classes start on Monday. Okay, when you are logged into my GCC, you have access to this link tab, whatever, drop down menu called GCC links, the golden arrow pointing to the GCC links. There are two things I really want you to, that you need to look at before classes start. One is, well, you really need to look at one and the other one I recommend. You really need to look at this remote and online learning for students. And then the other one is the new Moodle users classroom. It has a lot of details about Moodle, but some other technological things as well. We're gonna look at the remote and online learning for students course first. So when you get in here, there's information about the course in general, and then there are these various subject areas, these topics. And so they may be collapsed, they may be expanded. If they are collapsed, you just need to click on this arrow to expand them. So there's one that just kind of talks about what is this distance learning, one that talks about various video conferencing, one that talks about using Moodle. This is where I really want you to spend your time. If you have a Chromebook, there's a helpful section on Chromebooks and Moodle. And then there's skills for online learning. And so even if this isn't your first semester learning online, I really encourage you to check this out because it's always helpful to learn new skills. And there might be something here that you hadn't thought of before that will really help you as you embark on your time here at GCC. So looking at the using Moodle section, first thing you'll see is this tutorial, which is done by our own Gary Ackerman. It's like 8 minutes long. And it like walks you through what you need, you know, some various introductory stuff that you need to know, especially for those of us who need someone to like show us how it's done and then we're good. This is exactly what you need. Beneath that video, you will find a description of what's covered in the video, but also some opportunities to practice some key things that you will be doing in Moodle. So this is an opportunity to practice doing a post. So like if you have a discussion forum for a class, this, you know, this is exactly the kind of practice you need. This one's really this one's really helpful as well. This is how you practice submitting an assignment. You are going to need to submit assignments. This gives you an opportunity to try it before you're like in one of your classes. And last but not least, an opportunity to practice taking a quiz. So you can see why I really want you to spend some time on this using Moodle section so that when you have classes on Monday, it'll be less intimidating. You'll be like, wait, I got this. I've practiced. Now we're going to look at what you can find under the Moodle users classroom. There are a lot of sections, as you can see. And this is only like half of them. So this gives you some more details about navigating and customizing Moodle. When you're submitting assignments, mostly you have to submit PDFs. So this walks you through that. If you have to post, you'll be using the text editor. You might need to know how to manage YouTube videos. Here's more information about assignments, quizzes and grades for students. Again, Chromebooks and Moodle. Also some information, like I said, other tech stuff is here as well. So we use the G Suite here at GCC. So this gives you some information about that. And then here's the rest. Things about these other video platforms, other tools you might use, and then using Zoom. And what I wanna remind you is that this GCC links, this Moodle users classroom, the remote and online learning for students is available to you always. So we don't expect you to like learn and memorize everything now, but just remember that you always have this as a resource. You can always come back to this. Gary, did you want to say anything? I'm going to take that.
No, I'm sorry. You're right. You hit it all very well. Thank you.
Okay. Because Gary pulls this together. And so like, and if you have feedback or if there's something that's not covered, please let Gary know or let an instructor know. You know, we always want to make it more robust. All right, moving on to beginning the semester. So now we're going to talk about various offices and departments. And so first up is admissions and registrar. So the admissions office you should already be a little bit familiar with because you've been admitted to the college, which is why you are here. But there might be some things you still need admissions for. So if you need to submit CORI information for the program you're in, that goes to the admissions office. If you still need to submit a transcript from your high school or if you attended another college before coming to GCC, those transcripts get submitted to the admissions office. The registrar's office. The registrar's office maintains student records. So if you need an official copy of your transcript, and you will if you are planning to transfer, but you might need official copies of your transcript for various other reasons, you request that through the office of the registrar through their website. You might need to verify that you are a student at GCC for various reasons, maybe for a program that you're in, maybe to receive certain benefits, maybe for an employer. So those enrollment verifications are also done through the registrar's office. And again, you would do that through the registrar's office webpage. This is where I'm going to remind you about that quick links sheet that's in your orientation packet. There's a link to the registrar's office there and admissions as well. I mentioned quickly, you know, that if you need an unofficial transcript, you have access to that in MyGCC. You can just, you know, save it as a PDF or print it off as you need. So while the registrar's office also is in charge of officially changing majors and changing advisors, you actually can make those requests all on your own. That's one of those, that's one of the forms that are on the submit a form drop-down menu on MyGCC. So those are things you don't, you can just fill out the form and then you're pretty much good to go. All right, let's talk health records. The main thing I want you to take away is if all your classes are online, you are exempt from immunization requirements. So now if you have, or if any of your classes are not online, then these criteria that you need to meet, that like if these criteria apply to you, then you do need to submit immunization requirements, and you should have received emails about this already. And especially if you're in if you're a healthcare occupation student, regardless of how many credits you're doing, you have to submit immunization information. So main takeaway, all online, don't have to worry about this. Any in-person, make sure you know this information. There's a link to health records in the quick links as well. All right, paying for college. So we're gonna start talking about financial aid. So dual enrollment students, you don't have financial aid. That's not us, that's a federal government rule. You can take it up with them. But if you are planning to go, to go on to a four-year school, or like, you know, once you graduate, go, you know, do college, you're still going to need some information about financial aid. So this is still useful to you. The rest of you, this is also useful to you. All right. So the main thing to know about financial aid is, well, first of all, what I will tell you is, if you are a matriculated student, unless someone from our financial aid office has told you not to apply for financial aid, there's really no reason not to. You might have a brother's, cousin's, significant other who works at a college and said like, oh no, you'll never get financial aid, don't bother. But they don't work at GCC. Our students, you know, a lot of, like the majority of our students get financial aid. And if you have any questions about financial aid, you want to talk to the lovely folks in the financial aid office. All right, so the first thing to know about financial aid, you have to reapply every year. Financial aid is not a one and done this situation. And if you think about it, it makes perfect sense because people's financial situations change from year to year. And the federal government is going to have no way to know that unless they get information from you every year. So you have to apply every year. The application for next year has already opened. It opened on October 1st. You can still apply for financial aid for this semester. And if you haven't, you know, like I said, I encourage you to do so. For applying for next year, there is a priority deadline of May 1st. So if you can apply by May 1st, that will be to your benefit. But even if you can't, you should still apply after May 1st. There's still money to be had. Aid comes in three different versions. There's grants, so that's money that you don't need to pay back. There are loans, that is money that does need to be repaid, and you want to be careful with that. Again, any questions about that, please talk to the very knowledgeable FinAid folks. And work study. So work study is a job that you have on campus. It can be part of your financial aid package. It works like any other job. It's a position is posted, you apply for it, you have an interview of some kind usually, and then you get hired for the position, and then you work, you know, the agreed upon hours, and you fill out a time card, and you get a paycheck. But like I said, that's part of your financial aid packet, package. And it's, it's a job that you have on campus. And again, any questions, the FinAid folks are your friends. All right, some financial aid basics. So to be eligible for financial aid, you have to have your high school diploma or equivalency, be a U.S. citizen or green card holder, and have a declared major or certificate. The financial aid rules require that courses you are taking must be necessary prerequisites or direct requirements for the degree program you're pursuing. You know, definitely make sure you are familiar with the requirements for your program. In your orientation packet is a general degree audit for a basic liberal arts degree, but there's also a link to where you can find the degree audit for your, for all the programs. Most programs have space for you to take electives. So those electives can be any course that are of interest to you. So definitely, like I said, make sure you look at your degree audit so you have a sense of like what you should be taking. All right, this is really important. If you have financial aid and you're thinking of making a change to your schedule, so you want to drop a class or you want to add a class, especially dropping a class, make sure you check with the financial aid staff before you make any changes. Because sometimes those changes can affect your financial aid package and you want to know that before you make the change in case it affects the decision you make. So if you're thinking of making a change to your schedule, if your credits are going to stay the same, you probably are going to be fine. If you're not sure if it counts towards your program, you can talk to your advisor or FinAid. But again, checking with FinAid is really important. All right. So the financial aid comes from the federal government. Shockingly, the federal government is not like, here's money, go, I'm not paying any attention. No, the federal government wants to make sure that you are using the money the way it's intended. So if you aren't attending your classes, the federal government actually comes back and checks with us about attendance. And if we have to say like, nope, this person hasn't been attending class, then the federal government is going to come back to you and say, we want our money back. And that could be problematic. So if there's a reason why you can't attend your classes, don't just stop attending. Talk to someone, talk to the instructor, talk to your advisor, talk to financial aid. Excuse me. There are a lot of people to talk to just to see like what strategies you can come up with. And also, and maybe if you need to let a course go, financial aid may be able to say like, that's fine. You're still at this level and your award isn't going to change. The other thing you need to do is be making satisfactory academic progress towards your degree or certificate. So you need a minimum cumulative GPA. So that's an average of all your classes of a 2.0. A 2.0 is the equivalent of a C, and a 2.0 is also what you need to graduate. So that should be your very minimum goal. I'm sure all of you are aiming for much better than that. The other thing you need to do is make sure you complete 2/3 of the classes for which you are registered. So for example, if you were taking 3 classes that are 3 credits each, you need to pass and complete 2 of those to make sure that you are making satisfactory academic progress. Again, any questions about this, please talk to the lovely folks in financial aid. If you have questions about financial aid in general, whether or not you're eligible, how to apply for it, filling out the FAFSA, which is the free application for federal student aid, the financial aid can help with all of that. They literally will help you fill out the FAFSA. So if you're someone who like looks at those federal forms and like you just start, your mind goes blank and you're like, I can't, that's okay. They'll help you. So the FinAid folks are there to help you. They're so knowledgeable. They're really friendly. Definitely reach out to them. And again, you can find a link to the FinAid folks on that quick links form. Bursar's office. So some people get financial aid, everybody gets a bill. And the bursar's office is the folks who send out the bills. So spring bills were already due on January 5th. Hopefully you've paid them or made arrangements. If you make any changes to your schedule after that, then that generates a new bill. In the fall and spring semesters, you can set up a payment plan to spread that bill out over 4 months. It is very important to know that the first semester at GCC, they usually mail the bill. After that, you only get email notifications. So, and then you can access your bill through MyGCC. So again, this is another reason why it's really important to check your GCC email account. Oh, speaking of financial aid, that's another good reason to check your GCC email account. Because once you submit the FAFSA, that's not it. Like, then your information comes to GCC and then the FinAid folks email you because they need more information usually. And so that's another reason why you want to be checking your email on a regular basis. you can do online bill payment through MyGCC, and the bursar's office is also the office that processes student health insurance. Well, that wasn't what I wanted to do at all. Oh, good. There we go. Health insurance. So, all right, this is really important to pay attention to. This is not a GCC thing. This is a Commonwealth of Massachusetts thing. If you are enrolled in 9 or more credits, you are automatically enrolled in the student health insurance plan. This is the premium for the spring semester through the end of August. However, if you already have health insurance, you may be eligible to waive the school policy. There's an online waiver process. Again, that's through the state, so you have to create an account with them and complete the waiver form. You can find the link to that on the Bursar's office webpage. So if you go to the Bursar's office webpage, again, there's a link to that in the quick link sheet. And over here, once you're on their webpage, the tab that says health insurance, the last option is insurance waivers. You click on that, it'll walk you through the process. All right, here's an important piece of information to know. If you are planning to waive the health insurance, you need to do so before the first day of classes. The first day of classes is January 25th. That means you need to get that waiver request in by January 24th, so Sunday. You got 3 real days after today. You can do it this evening if you want. All right. Let's talk FERPA. FERPA stands for the Family Education Rights and Privacy Act. It is a federal law. It applies to all college students across the nation, regardless of age. And what it says is your records are your own and we cannot talk to other people about them. So this is why if you reach out to someone and you do it through an email account that's not your GCC email, you might not get a response. Or you might get a response, but it goes to your GCC email, because the only way we know that it's you is if it's you, if it's coming from your GCC email account. So this applies to academic records, but it also applies to financial information as well. Many people have other folks that help them with their college bills. And so if you would like that person who is helping you with the with your college bill to just have their own access to the billing information, and that's the only access it's going to give them, then you need to fill out a FERPA waiver. You want to make sure. So if you, like I said, you want somebody else to be able to look at your billing information, sign the FERPA waiver so that they can have access to that. Again, it's only to the billing stuff. It won't let them call up your advisor and ask how you're doing in your English class. All right. Advising. So a couple of things. I'm checking the time. Yes. Oh, God, we're doing great. All right. So we're going to go through advising, including the section on career services, and then we are going to take a break. Okay. So don't worry. A break is coming. What I'm going to do. So last week when I played these videos directly from Prezi, they were laggy and they didn't work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out to YouTube and play these directly from YouTube, assuming I can get to the tab I want. These Zoom controls have not gotten out of my way this whole time. Let me try one other thing. I will not be defeated. Okay, so let me find the advising video. Here we go. So this is the first one. So Tanya's name is misspelled, but this is Tanya Blunden. She has 2 videos and she's gonna talk to you about advising.
Hi, I'm Tanya Blunden, Director of Advising and Transfer. On behalf of the Academic Advising Center team, welcome to GCC. We want to help you make the most of your time here, whether it's one semester or years. In the Academic Advising Center, you will find staff advisors, the transfer coordinator, our adult basic ed transition to college program, and peer mentors. Every student at GCC is assigned an academic advisor during the first week of the semester. It doesn't matter if you're taking 1 credit or 15. Some of you will be assigned to one of our staff advisors in the Advising Center, and others will be assigned to a faculty member in your field of study. You can find your assigned academic advisor in your MyGCC account. You can also change your academic advisor. Maybe your assignment isn't a good fit, or maybe you have a professor that you really love and want to work more closely with. Either way, there's a quick and easy form you can complete in MyGCC to request a reassignment. So now that you know who we are, you might be wondering what an advisor does or why you should talk to yours. These are great questions. You spoke to an advisor in order to register for your first semester classes. Helping you make your schedule is one thing your advisor does, but there is so much more. You can think of your advisor as the tour guide to your time at GCC. We're here to help you find out where you want to go and make sure you don't miss any of the sites along the way. In addition to registering for classes, your advisor can help you think about your interests and skills, create an academic plan that goes beyond just one semester, make connections between your major and careers of interest, explore transfer opportunities, talk through tricky situations like not doing well in a class or thinking about changing your major, and they can connect you with other resources at GCC and in the community. There are lots of opportunities to take advantage of at GCC. It's never too early, but it can be too late. One of those opportunities is transfer. GCC students transfer to many different institutions locally, including UMass Amherst, Westfield State, Smith, Mount Holyoke, as well as schools across the country. You really can start here and go anywhere. That said, there's a lot of moving parts to the transfer process. The earlier you start thinking about it, the more choices you will have. You don't need to be 100% certain about what you want to do to begin the process. So whether it's about transfer, your schedule, or your academic goals, I invite you to start the conversation today. Your advisor is ready for you.
I forgot I was muted. Now I'm unmuted. All right, so, and now we're gonna talk about important dates. When I say we, I mean Tanya.
There are many opportunities for you to make changes to your schedule throughout the semester. If you are taking standard classes, which are classes that start on the first day of the semester and run all the way through the term, then you can find those important deadlines on the academic calendar. The academic calendar is available directly in your MyGCC account. When you log into MyGCC, you'll see it here. There are a couple of important deadlines coming up pretty quickly. For example, Friday, January 29th, is the last day that you can add classes for this semester. Friday, January 29th is also the last day that you can drop a class and still receive a 100% refund. After Friday, you have until February 5th in order to drop a class and receive a 75% refund. You can still drop classes after that February 5th deadline, but no refund will be attached to the drop. Again, this is for our standard classes, those that run for the entire semester. We also have a number of classes that start late or end early. These are called non-standard classes, and they carry their own add and drop deadlines. The best way to find that information is from the GCC homepage, to use the search bar by typing in non-standard deadlines. And the first result will link you to the registrar's webpage. Here you can find a list of all of our non-standard classes for the spring with each one's important deadlines. Look for the course that you're taking and follow the line across to make sure you know when you can add the class, when you can drop it with a full refund, when you can drop it with a 75% refund, and the remaining deadlines for the semester. If you ever have any questions about this or you're unsure what kind of class you're taking, please reach out to your academic advisor or contact the Academic Advising Center.
All right, great. So I'm gonna stop sharing for a second so I can get back to the Prezi. Now, coming back to Zoom, share my screen again. All right, so we just saw Tanya's videos. So just a couple of things, you know, just to reiterate what Tanya said. So everyone has an advisor, regardless of the number of credits they're in. They have a variety of advisors, staff advisors, faculty advisors. As I pointed out, when we looked at the MyGCC dashboard, that you can find your assigned advisor there. I think it's also on the left-hand side on your menu. And just to remember that advising is about more than just registering for classes. Advisors can help you with major and career exploration, academic planning, understanding the transfer process. They can give you, you're connected to resources and supports. They're, you know, a really just, they're an excellent resource for you. So, and then the advising, Academic Advising Center is a lot of help in one place. They have academic advisors, the transfer coordinator, the internship coordinator, Bob Barba, he's so lovely. Career Services is there, peer mentors. So there's a lot of things to connect with. And again, you can find a link to their website on the quick links page. And as you know, Tanya talked about, it's never too early to connect with them. And even if you, you know, especially if you're thinking about transferring at all, and even if you don't think you want to transfer, I would still, like, it's a good connection to make because you want to be planning ahead. She talked about the important dates, so you can add a class through that Friday. So this is something to pay really close attention to. You know, often our classes start midweek, and so you have until the following, like, say, Tuesday to make a decision. The way the schedule is working this year is that you have, you know, classes start on the Monday the 25th, and you have only until Friday the 29th to add a class. And then that's also until the 29th to receive 100% refund. You can still drop a class during the second week, that's through February 5th, and that gets you a 75% refund. And there are other dates, of course, to let go of classes. Again, if you are thinking about making any changes to your schedule, don't do that all on your own. You want to talk to two people. You want to talk to your advisor, and you want to talk to someone in financial aid. If you don't have financial aid, then you don't have to talk to someone in financial aid, but everybody else should talk to financial aid. You want to make sure you're making informed decisions and that there aren't any repercussions later. All right, we're going to talk about career services, and then we are going to take a break. So Career Services is focused on empowering GCC students to become career ready so that you can make informed career and education decisions so that you are prepared for both applying for internships and jobs, so that you are doing, when you're choosing education and activities, those are, you're thinking about like what you might want to do when you're making choices about that. And then having a connection, you know, employment opportunities and work connections. I think there's someone who's not muted, and I can't see who it is, but if you could please make sure you're muted, that would be great. Things to be thinking of are, what are my career goals and how do I get there from here? And I know for some of us, it can be intimidating, especially if you're like, I don't know what I want to do, but that's where Career Services comes in handy because they can help you figure that out. And so now I'm going to turn things over to Shannon Duran. I think I just mispronounced her name again. I do it every time. and she's going to talk to you about career services. Wellness Center, tutoring, career services. I'm going to try making this one full screen. I'm a concerned.
Hello, my name is Shannon Duran.
So if it does, someone let me know. Oh, see, that was a mistake. All right, we'll see how it goes.
I'm the Career Services Coordinator at Greenfield Community College, and it's my honor and delight to both invite and encourage you to take full advantage of Career Services during your time at GCC. Career Services, we focus on supporting students in a few key areas. Ideally, that would begin with goal setting and action planning. Research shows that when we write down our goals, especially if those are combined with action steps and some time frames, our ability to achieve our goals greatly increases. The second phase of support that benefits most students is career exploration and decision-making. And I have to say, even students that I've worked with who thought they knew exactly where they're going often benefited from taking a couple of career assessments, engaging in some additional self-reflection, getting some additional feedback from people that know them well, and also getting some experience in those areas that they're interested in. We tend to call these work-based learning experiences. Those are things like mentorship, internships, maybe community service, college service, and sometimes even employment. There's a way that that combination of kind of research and exploration can empower us to make much more informed and strategic decisions. I know that all of us here are deeply invested in you getting everything you can out of GCC. And if you have more clarity about where you want to go after GCC, you can backwards design and make choices about your education that will be more strategic and effective. An additional area that we hope to support you in developing is your readiness to apply and obtain employment. We want to help you learn effective strategies and also get those different documents, including an e-portfolio, together that many employers will want to see in order to grant you an interview and move forward in the hiring process. We want you to get work. We want you to thrive. We want all of your knowledge and skills to be able to have the greatest impact they can. And when it comes to career services, there's a tremendous amount of resources on our career services website, which I hope you will utilize. Additionally, there's a chat feature on the website. Please feel free to use it if you have any questions or immediate needs. I can also be reached by email at careerservices@gcc.mass.edu. And there will be many, many different workshops and events happening all semester. So again, if you make a plan, you set some goals, I encourage you to kind of look at that schedule and engage, take advantage of the opportunities that will really inform and help you move forward on achieving those goals. So thank you again. My name is Shannon Doran, Career Services, and I look forward to working with you.
We talked about this a little bit at the beginning. Now we're going to talk about it a little bit more. So one of the themes that we have for orientation and really GCC in general is that asking for help is a sign of strength. So I don't know why, but our society has this weird false narrative about what asking for help indicates. And what it really indicates is that it is not an indication of weakness, which is, for some reason, that's the message. But really it is a sign of strength, because what it is it's recognizing that, like, you know what, I don't have this all on my own. And honestly, nobody has anything all on their own. Like, no one is solely successful. Everyone has, you know, the support, you know, supports along the way. So, and GCC is a community college. And so we're here to support all the members of the community that come our way. And so we want you to be successful. So we have a lot of resources for you. So take advantage of them. So we're going to talk about academic resources, personal support resources, and then other student resources. Starting with academic support resources, we're going to start with the library. So when we get back to campus, the library is probably the prettiest space on campus. It's very popular with students. They have different areas of, like, it is not a quiet library, but some areas are quieter than other areas. They have all these beautiful windows. And a lot of students, like, spend their time here between classes getting work done. So when we get back to campus, I encourage you to check it out. But even though we're not on campus, that doesn't mean that the library doesn't still have a whole host of resources for you. And one of the things you want to be able to do is get a library card, which you can do remotely. So if you go to the library website, and over here on the right hand side, you can see it says get a library card. And if you click on that, you can fill out the form. It's very fast. But also notice in the lower right hand corner of the library's webpage is this little chat feature. This is a fabulous feature. So you click on that and you can chat with a librarian. They can help you with a variety of things. They help students with tech issues sometimes. They help students, you know, obviously if they need help with a research paper, that sort of thing. But also, just any question you might have, GCC related or not GCC related. Remember, librarians are your friend, but also they're nerds, and what they love to do is find stuff out. So please take advantage. And their librarians are so amazing. I am seriously in awe of them. So the library has a tech equipment lending library. So you can check out things that you might need to do your classes. They do the one-on-one help that you might need with any sort of research project. They have tech support. If you check the website, you'll see their hours. That's enough of me telling you about the library. I'm going to turn things over to Lorena, who's going to give you the information about the library from the library perspective. Now I just need to find her video. There she is. There they are.
Hi, I'm Lorena, a librarian at the GCC Library, and we'd like to welcome you to GCC. At the library, our whole job is to make sure that you have what you need in order to succeed and do your best academic work. We support students in two different ways. One is by providing material, such as books and technology, that you may need. Our Tech Lending Library is a resource for students to access equipment, such as laptops and Wi-Fi hotspots. And two, by providing support in order for you to have the necessary research and technology skills to succeed. It's our job to help you answer any questions that may arise during your academic career here at GCC. No question is too big or too small, and we are not going to evaluate you, and we are not judgmental. You can ask us anything, and if we don't have the answer, we'll point you in the right direction. Librarians are available to assist you virtually during library hours or by appointment. We can answer any questions you have on services, regular research concerns, or technology issues. Students generally find us in person, but don't worry. Librarian support is available remotely, and you can contact us via our chat, video chat, phone call, text, or email. We can also schedule one-on-one appointments with students via Zoom, Google Meet, and Jitsi. We encourage students to get a library card as soon as the semester begins. Your library card not only allows you to access materials and to check them out, but also to access our online library databases. In order to sign up for a library card, please visit the library's website and click on Get a Library Card on the green banner located under the white catalog search box. It only takes a minute to fill out that form, so you might as well request a library card after this video. If you have any questions, please contact us, and we will be happy to help. We look forward to working with you. Please check out our library social media pages and follow us. Thank you.
Hello, my name is
All right, so that was very helpful information from Lorena. And now we're going to talk about peer tutoring. I'm just going to leave this small because I'm going to fly out to YouTube in a second anyway. Peer tutoring is free to any GCC student. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have Hannah White, who's one of the peer tutors, talk to you about peer tutoring, and then I'll reiterate a couple of things that she has to say.
Hi there, my name's Hannah White, and I'm one of the writing tutors in GCC's peer tutoring program. This video is going to be a short introduction to what peer tutoring is, how to access it in this new virtual environment that we're living in, and how you might want to use peer tutoring for help in your courses at GCC. Peer tutoring is a free service for all GCC students. Between all of the tutors, we tutor content in pretty much every course offered at GCC, including math, languages, science, and writing in any subject. One-on-one tutoring appointments typically last for about 50 minutes, and they are available at a mutually agreed upon time. We are currently tutoring virtually via Google Meet, which is a video conferencing platform that is automatically installed in all of your GCC student email accounts, which means you don't have to worry about installing anything new on your computer. We also have a tip sheet available on how to use Google Meet on our website. In order to schedule a peer tutoring appointment, you can go to our website, which is gcc.mass.edu/tutoring. You'll also find a link to peer tutoring embedded in your Moodle page, listed under Student Support. Once you're on our website, you should see a big orange rectangular button that says Request an Appointment on it. If you click on this button, it will take you to a separate form, which you should fill out in full, and then hit Submit. After you've submitted your request for a tutoring appointment, you should remember to check your GCC student email account on a regular basis because a staff member will be contacting you as soon as possible to confirm your appointment. You can also call our reception number, which is 413-775-1330. And if no one answers, you can leave a message and a staff member will get back to you as soon as possible. A lot of things could happen in your tutoring session depending on what you're working on and what you want help with. In terms of writing appointments, tutors can help you at any stage of the writing process, from brainstorming paper ideas to reviewing and revising your drafts. A math tutoring session might include things like helping you work through a problem or test corrections. A tutoring session for a language course might include activities like practicing speaking world languages with your tutor, such as French, Spanish, or sign language. Tutors can also help you with general study skills. For example, we can share strategies for scheduling your time, note-taking, reading, and studying for your exams. I also just want to highlight that you don't have to be struggling in course to benefit from peer tutoring. Even we tutors get tutored by our fellow tutors because it's just really helpful for us. Thanks for listening, and I hope I get to see you soon.
Can you go back one second so I can write down that email?
Oh, it's in the it's on the quick links. So you can it's right. So yeah. So if you go to the orientation packet, you can find that right there. So. All right. So.
Hi. Although I want to say kudos for taking notes.
Absolutely. All right. I'm gonna pause sharing for a second. No, that didn't do what I wanted to do. All right. Back to our Prezi. All right, so there's a couple of things that Hannah talked about that I just want to reiterate. So it's free to any GCC student, and it's not about whether or not you're struggling. It's just about whether you want to be doing better in a class. Maybe you have a C and what you really want is to get the most out of the class and get a higher grade than that. They have support for math and writing and most courses. If they don't have a tutor for a specific course that you need help in, they'll do their best to find one. But also it's not just assistance with specific classes, but they can help, as they talked about, with study strategies and note-taking and time management. But do you know what else they can do? And this is what I have my students do, is set up an appointment with a peer tutor at the beginning of the semester to A, go over your Moodle courses to make sure you understand how each one works and where everything's located, because as I mentioned, different instructors set them up differently. And then the other thing they can do is go over your syllabi with you so that you know what's expected of you in the course, when things are due, how your grade is being calculated, that sort of thing. So I really encourage you to, connect with a peer tutor early just to kind of go over those things, make sure you're clear about them. And then once you've done that, once you realize how easy it is to set up a peer tutoring appointment, and you're that much more likely to take advantage of it for a specific class if you need to. All right, the math studio. So when we are on campus, there are studios for different academic areas. While we are virtual, the math department has theirs going virtually. And so the math studio is a place for both students and faculty to go and talk math. And it's also a great place if it's another resource for you if you need help with a math problem or with your math homework. You can just drop into the virtual math studio and you can find information about that on the math department's website. And there is a link to it on the quick link sheet. So definitely I encourage you to check that out. And then All right, so now we're going to talk about personal support resources, and we're going to talk about first the Wellness Center. The Wellness Center is where you find counseling services and disability and accessibility services. And so first, we're going to hear from Colleen Caffrey, and who is the coordinator of disability and accessibility services. We're going to hear from Cindy Kuntz, who is the learning specialist, and Carol Leary, who's the administrative assistant. And we're going to pop out to YouTube to look at those videos.
Hi, my name is Colleen Caffrey.
And I'm Cindy Kuntz, but you can call me Sin.
And I'm Carol Leary.
We, along with Kathleen Keough, our learning support counselor, are the Wellness Center at GCC. I have the privilege of working with students with disabilities to remove the barriers that prevent them from accessing the programs and services at GCC. The students I work with have a variety of challenges, from physical ones to invisible ones, like mental health challenges and learning disabilities. I also work with students with temporary conditions like concussions. So the way it works, you make an appointment by calling Carol. When we're on campus, we meet in my office. Off campus, we meet over Zoom. We talk about your experiences and challenges, look over your documentation, and if you're eligible for accommodations, we create an accommodation agreement, which you can then give to your instructors at the beginning of each semester. Over to you, Sin.
Thanks. I'm the learning specialist, and students are referred to me, usually by Colleen, for help in developing academic strategies that are based on their accommodations. And we'll look at the strengths of your particular learning style and then boost up the areas where you might need some support. I oversee assistive technology and trainings for things like smart pens and dictation or reading software. We can work together on time management and organization systems that actually work for you, so you don't get overwhelmed and you can stay on track. Some students meet with me every week all semester, and others meet with me just a few times and are pretty good to go. The best way to contact me for a Zoom appointment is through email. Take it away, Carol.
Well, as the Wellness Center's learning administrative assistant, I not only provide administrative support for our staff, I also provide reception for our students. Whether you're looking for information about the services we provide, maybe where and how do you send us your documentation, or you'd like to set up a schedule a meeting with one of our staff, all you have to do is call me. I'm easy to find. My contact information's on the GCC website under both disability services and counseling services, right on the homepage.
I'm also the advisor for the Neurodiversity Club. I'm sure you will be receiving information about clubs once the semester gets started, but if you're interested in learning more about the Neurodiversity Club before then, feel free to contact me.
And I'm the host of the Hot Mess Express, a support group that's open to all students who want to learn a little bit about the brain and how to conquer habits like procrastination that can totally derail your semester. So keep an eye on your student email for more information, and I hope to see you here on Zoom.
So please do get in touch if we can help in any way. If we're not who you need, we can connect you with the right person. We'd much rather be talking to you than sitting in our offices all by ourselves. See you soon. Bye.
Bye.
All right, and now we're going to hear from Kathleen Keough, our learning support counselor, and Jackson Taylor and Yadira Rahman, who are GCC students. And yes, Jackson's name might look familiar. We will go look at that video now.
Hello, my name's Kathleen Keough, and I'm the counselor in the Wellness Center Counseling Office. Welcome to GCC. One of my favorite things about my job is working with students like you.
College can be exciting and challenging, especially when you're working, caring for a family, and trying to maintain a well-balanced life. While at times you might find ways to cope with this, all of these things can become overwhelming. You may find yourself stressed, depressed, or experience anxiety. All those feelings have the potential to diminish your ability to focus and concentrate on your academics.
GCC cares about your personal wellness as much as your academic success. Asking for help during these times is a sign of strength. Seeking support from a counselor in the Wellness Center will most likely lead to finding some solutions for you to be supported through these challenging times. No problem is too small or too big.
One-to-one confidential counseling is available to all registered students who want to talk about stress, anxiety, family issues, or any personal concerns that may get in the way of your academic success. These come at no additional cost as they are part of your tuition.
As much as I'd love to meet you on campus, that's not possible during these unprecedented times. Counseling services are offered remotely. Some students last semester felt a little awkward at first, but once they got used to it, they really found it very, very helpful. So if you have any questions about counseling, don't hesitate to ask.
You may wonder, how can you make an appointment? Counseling sessions are by appointment on weekdays between 9:30 and 4:30 p.m. Call the Wellness Center at 413-775-1332 or 413-775-1337. You can call, ask for an appointment, and ask any questions you may have. After your telephone conversation, you can find the requests for the counseling forms and the confidentiality forms on the Wellness Center webpage. You can upload them after you complete them within 24 hours prior to your appointment time. It is that simple.
The counseling process can be an educational experience for you. Typically, meetings are focused on the temporary problems of daily living rather than psychological disorders. You may not only learn about yourself, but learn new skills to cope with personal, social, and academic demands.
So contact us. What do you have to lose? And you have everything to gain. My experience at GCC is any student who reaches out for the multiple supports we have on campus are our most successful students.
Go for it.
You won't be disappointed. And just a reminder that, links to the Wellness Center are on that quick links page that's in your orientation packet. And also, I just wanted to point out that I know in the video they say that you should call, but if you want to set up an appointment with Kathleen, you really can just reach out to her directly via email to get the process started. She really is very eager to help students during this time. And she's really easy to talk to. And honestly, all the folks in the Wellness Center are really lovely. I can't stress enough how helpful they are. And I want to circle back to something that, Colleen, who is our coordinator for disability and accessibility services. One other thing I just want to circle back to is if you have had, experience with that, say in high school, and it wasn't the best experience, you might feel like you want to not do that, work with her. And I can't stress enough how easy Colleen is to work with. And also I really want to stress that high school and college are very different. I can also want to tell you that as someone who has been in higher ed for a long time, I have seen, unfortunately, too frequently, students who should have accommodations but didn't seek them out because they just wanted to try something new. They wanted to try it all on their own, which I totally get. But then it has a negative impact on their academic performance and their GPA, and that doesn't really reflect what they can do. And so the way it works is you set up a meeting with Colleen, you have a conversation, the two of you agree what the accommodations are, she writes them up. She gives them to you, and then it's up to you to share them with your instructors. But you want to have them in place sooner rather than later so that you have them when you need them. So definitely, connect with Colleen. And if you are looking for someone to talk to, I really recommend connecting with Kathleen as well. All right, back to our Zoom meeting. Just kidding, not that way, this way. All right, so counseling services is here to provide individualized support, as Kathleen talked about. Disability and accessibility services are here to support students to promote independence and facilitate achievement of educational goals. So a really great office to work with. So GCC has a food pantry. We have the second oldest college food pantry in the nation because early on we recognized that our students, that food insecurity was an issue for many of our students. And we specifically recognized that, like, you can't be your best academic self if you are hungry or if you're worried about how to feed your family. So if we were on campus, we have a physical food pantry where you could go and pick up food and personal items. While we're remote, the food pantry is working a little differently. If you are experiencing food insecurity, just email the food pantry at gcc.mass.edu. And again, there is a link to this on that quick links page. And they will work with you to help with those issues. So we definitely, we're still looking out for you even while we are remote. All right. We're getting very close to the end, friends. all right, we're gonna talk about other student resources. So the Office of Student Activities and Community Service, I'm going to let Mary McEntee, who is the coordinator for student activities, talk to you about that. And then I am going to talk a bunch about why it is important to get involved on campus.
Hi, my name is Mary McEntee, and I'm coordinator of student activities at Greenfield Community College. Welcome to GCC. So part of what I do is I oversee the Greenfield Community College Student Senate, which is the representative body of the student population to the GCC students and administration. So I'm always looking for people that are interested in running for student senate. If you're interested, please contact me. You can find me via the website, or you can email me at mcenteem@gcc.mass.edu. Student Senate meets every other week on Mondays virtually from 12 to 1. And we also oversee student clubs. So we have a permaculture club, Dungeons and Dragons club, multicultural club, entrepreneurship club, along with many others that we have listed on our website. And if you don't see the club that you're interested in, you can make and create that club by filling out the paperwork. So all our clubs meet virtually through Moodle. So there's plenty of opportunities to interact with peers that have the same interests as you. And we also have an advisor for each club, which is oftentimes one of the faculty in our department. So Trevor Kearns is the faculty advisor for the Dungeons and Dragons Club. We have Holly Lovelace as the advisor for the Vets and Allies Club. So this is a great way to take advantage of one-on-one resources. We also process your student ID cards, and this year we'll be doing those virtually where you upload your photo from home. So if you log on to MyGCC, you'll see in the corner there's a spot that reads upload your photo. So please follow directions, upload your photo, and I will print your ID card and get it to you via mail. I hope you enjoy your time at New Student Orientation, and I look forward to working with each and every one of you. Take care.
All right, so I wanna, so we are remote, but that doesn't mean that you can't get involved on our virtual campus. And I'm going to really encourage those of you who have time to do so for a couple of reasons. One, the thing that makes GCC so special is the people, and you are those people. And so this is a way to like connect with each other. The other reason is that they've done research on college students, obviously, and one of the things they've found out is that students who are involved on their campuses feel more connected to their institutions and do better academically. So it's good for your academics as well. As I mentioned, there are virtual things that are meetings that are going on. Mary talked about that as well. And so you can find out about that. So she talked about the ID. If you log into MyGCC under My Announcements, you should have something that says Student ID. Click here to upload a picture and receive a Student ID by mail. So that gives you all the requirements for what you need to do. And just important to note, the deadline to submit a photo is February 5th, and then Mary will be printing those out and mailing them to you. So you want to make sure your mailing address is correct in the system. Speaking about getting involved, in your orientation packet, both on the quick links form, but also there's a sheet about that with a link to this, is a link to the student activities interest form. And so that's a Google form that you fill out, and you can say, like, these are the things I'm interested in. And then that's how you'll be notified about them. So I really encourage you to fill out that form. You can do that right after orientation this evening, in fact. And I'm sure the orientation leaders are actually, you know, talking about various things to get involved in the chat as I speak. And then the other thing I want to talk to you about is we have a GCC Slack channel that we started last semester. So it's a way to connect while we're remote, and it kind of takes the place of like what would happen if we were on campus and you were like walking the hallways and saw one of your friends, or you were in the dining hall and you saw some people that looked familiar. You know, it's just an opportunity to kind of hang out. There is a link for this GCC Student Slack channel, again, in that quick links page. Also, there's a page for it in the orientation packet. That's something, again, you can sign up for right after this. And I know some of our orientation leaders are very involved in the Slack channel and can talk more about it. So the thing that one of the things I really like about orientation is that we have this, you know, this great conversation that's happening in the chat. And then, especially when we're remote, it can be like, well, where do we go with this? And the answer is to the Slack channel. So I definitely encourage you to check that out. All right, the Veterans Center is a network of support services for student veterans, their friends, family, and allies. If you're receiving vet benefits, you need to make sure if you haven't already done so, you want to make sure you meet with Holly Lovelace. She's the GI Bill certifying official. We also have a student veterans club. When we're back on campus, it's a community space for setting and socializing. And they have free coffee and PB&J every day for anyone. You don't even have to be a vet. Just FYI. So if this is your first semester using the GI Bill or National Guard benefits at GCC, you need to have a one-on-one personalized orientation with Holly Lovelace. You know how complicated that stuff is, and she will walk you through it. She's fabulous. She knows her stuff, and she is on top of it. Also, she's just so friendly. All right, inclusion and diversity. So when we are on campus, the inclusion and diversity, and this is not the only way inclusion and diversity happen at GCC, but the Inclusion and Diversity Center is a dedicated physical space that promotes community, equity, unity, social gathering, and cross-cultural understanding among students. Everyone's welcome, but especially those who have been traditionally underrepresented in college. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn things over to our former Dean of Humanities, Engineering, Math, and Science, Leo Wong, who is going to talk about a variety of ways that you can get connected to issues related to diversity and inclusion. His video is very soft, so I will turn up my volume once I get this started. First, I have to find him.
And while
there we are.
She's looking for that. I just want to let everybody know that President Eve is going to be holding a conversation that's specifically for students of color to just check in, see how the year's been going, see how your GCC experience is. So that's going to be another thing that will be hitting your email inboxes. So look out for that probably in February sometime.
All right. Oh man, that's so loud in my ear. Here we go.
Hello, my name is Leo Huang, and I'm the Dean of Humanities, Engineering, Math, and Science at GCC. I'm here to talk to you about the different ways you can engage in diversity, equity, and inclusion at Greenfield Community College. At GCC, we pride ourselves on the wide range of courses that are social justice-based and focus on equity and racial justice. Here's just a sample of some of the courses you can take while at GCC. Elementary American Sign Language, The Social Impact of Mass Media, Social Issues in Criminal Justice, An Introduction to Special Education, Queer Literature, Women in Literature, Modern Global Literature, Gender and the Environment, An Introduction to Gender and Women's Studies, History of African American Peoples, Women and Gender in the American West to 1920, The Legal History of American Civil Rights, World Music and Cultures, Intercultural Communications, American Civil Liberties, Psychology of Women and Gender, Social Inequality, and the Sociology of Gender. In addition to these cool courses, there are lots of wonderful cultural events that you can engage in, even while we are socially distancing through Zoom. And if you're interested in clubs, there's the Diversity Committee, the Social Justice Club, the International Students Club, the Inclusion and Diversity Center, and many more opportunities. Most of all, I want you to know that GCC is here to support you and all the things that make you a unique and valuable individual. If you ever have a question about how to get involved with social justice issues at GCC, or if you ever need help finding the resources you need, feel free to shoot me an email at hwangl@gcc.mass.edu. Thank you and have a wonderful semester.
So as I mentioned, Leo is our former dean. He left us last semester. We are still sad about that. But I wanted to share that video with you because he does share a lot of helpful information. If you are looking for, you know, information about opportunities for, you know, diversity and inclusion, Lillian Ruiz is the director of the Diversity and Inclusion Center, Inclusion and Diversity Center, sorry. And so you can absolutely reach out to her. And you know, you can also, and the link to the website is of course on the quick links page. So that is also there. Let me get to where I want to go. All right, so we heard from Leo. The Women's Resource Center, oh, wait, this is when I get to turn things over to Anna so that I can stop talking at you and you can listen to someone else besides me. So Anna, I'm gonna turn this over to you.
It was a good thing I was paying attention, huh?
Yes.
So the Women's Resource Center is both services and a space. And of course, now that we're not on campus, it is really just services. And it is available to all students regardless of gender identity. We have specific resources available for those who identify as women, and we have other resources for any other student. Some of those resources are financial support, but probably the most important, I know money sounds important, but probably the most important resources are the advocacy that Rosemary Freeland, the coordinator of the Women's Resource Center, and Diana Abbott, who is an advocate in the center, can offer to you. So they're available to serve in advising roles. They can offer you planning and coaching activities related to any host of different issues. Since the pandemic, we've had a significant increase in our donations to our student emergency fund. And so sometimes we can assist with things like paying for books if you don't have enough money in your financial aid to pay for books, or if you don't get financial aid. Sometimes students have trouble making their electric bill or things like that. So there are two different ways that you can get support with those. One is this Look for Help resource, which is a link on the Women's Resource Center webpage that tells you about all kinds of different community resources that can help with any host of different basic needs. And then the orange button, Request Support Assistance, is a way to request support through the Women's Resource Center. And that support may be, hey, I need help finding childcare, or it may be, hey, I need help paying for my childcare this month because I'm short on money. So check out both of those different resource areas on the Women's Resource Center website, and that'll connect you with Rosemary and or Diana.
Great, thank you, Anna.
You bet.
All right, just real quick, when we're on campus, we have a fitness center. It's free. It's awesome. You should check it out, but we're not going to spend a lot of time there because we can't take advantage of it right now. Also on campus is a community resource studio, which is where they have recovery meetings, but we still have recovery meetings even while we're remote. Those are on Thursdays from 12 to 12:50 for anyone who identifies as being in recovery or with a loved one in recovery. And you should keep your eye out for an email from Judy Raper for more information about those meetings. Judy also, another one of the things that Judy coordinates is our mentoring program. And so she has a video where she talks about both of the recovery meetings and the mentoring program. So I'm going to turn things over to her. It is clear that she made this video in the spring because there's some references to the fall, but they still apply in the spring. And this video is kind of jumpy. So it's the quality of the video. It's not the quality of the connection. And here she is.
Hi, everyone. My name is Judy Raper. I'm the Associate Dean of Community Engagement at Greenfield Community College. And I'm here to tell you about two resources that are available to you as you start your journey at GCC. First of all, welcome. We are so happy to have you here and are very much hoping that we'll be able to see you in person on campus in the spring. Until then, I wanted to make you aware that we do have resources for students who are either in recovery or have a family member who's in recovery or struggling with a substance abuse disorder. While normally our meetings are held in our community resource studio in the East Building at GCC, for the fall semester, these meetings will be held remotely. You'll be receiving an email from me that lets you know when the first meeting is in early September. And if you're unable to make it, you can email me and let me know what might be a better time for you. These meetings will occur on a weekly basis and be open to anyone who identifies as being in recovery or has a loved one in recovery. Secondly, I wanted to make you aware of a mentoring program that we have. We have numerous older adults in our community, most of whom have had a college experience and had a career, who are looking to be an additional layer of support for you. So if you're interested in having a mentor, there's a simple application that you will fill out online, and then you'll have the opportunity to look through some profiles of some mentors in the community that you might want to work with. I will be in touch once you are on campus, so please look for an email from me. Again, my name is Judy Raper, Associate Dean for Community Engagement, and I can be reached by email at rapersinpaulerj@gcc.mass.edu. Again, welcome. We are so happy to have you, and enjoy your orientation.
All right, so Judy talked about the recovery meetings, and then she also talked about the mentoring program. So there's a link for Judy's email in the quick link sheet, and there's a link to the mentoring page where you can fill out an application. I really encourage you to take advantage of the mentoring program. It's always nice to have someone who's just in your corner, someone who doesn't have like a specific agenda for you, just has your back, someone who, you know, is, you know, neutral and you can talk to. I will also, the other thing I'll say about the mentoring program is that one of our former orientation leaders, Hannah, signed up for the mentoring program this past fall, and she could not say enough nice things about the program and her mentor. She just adored her mentor. So I really encourage you to take advantage of it. Look for that. And then friends, I promise we are getting close to the end. So bookstore, GCC has a bookstore. So it's an online bookstore for now, even though it does have physical space. So to order your books, you do that through the bookstore. You can go to their website. They have textbooks, software, but they also have things like, you know, notebooks and supplies and GCC stuff, you know, swag, and that sort of thing. And a little known secret is that the bookstore actually does price matching. So if you can show them that you can find the same textbook for less money from a different vendor, then they'll match that price. So that's information about the bookstore. And again, a link to that is on the quick link sheet. If you're having trouble, you know, buying your books, talk to your advisor, use that link on the women's resource page that Anna was talking about. And now I turn things over to Anna again to talk about equal opportunity and diversity and then public safety.
And we are truly in the home stretch, right, Tamitha?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So one of the things that's important for us to talk about as you're entering into a college is that you're going to encounter some ideas that maybe make you feel a little uncomfortable. And in 1972, there was a Supreme Court case that basically ended with education is the marketplace of ideas, or at least a college education is. And sometimes you're going to hear things you're going to disagree with. Sometimes you're going to hear things that make you uncomfortable. And anyone can really participate in what's called the marketplace of ideas. You've all heard of free speech. Now, certainly that doesn't mean you can say anything you want to. And free speech also comes with consequences if you say things that are problematic for some folks. John F. Kennedy said it best when he talked about this idea of having values and ideas. And what he said is we're subject to facts. We're subject all to the facts that are prefabricated set of interpretations, which means so many of the things that we think we believe are facts and they aren't always. Sometimes we enjoy the comfort of an opinion without the getting uncomfortable and really thinking about what it is. So what we ask you to do is get uncomfortable, challenge yourself, challenge each other, step out of what I like to refer to as terminable certainty, which means you think that there's no change in your mind because you know something deeply. And that may be true. You might know something so deeply, you're not going to change your mind. But it's surprising how sometimes we can have our minds changed. Go ahead, Tamitha. So I'm sure all of you have heard of affirmative action, equal opportunity, and diversity. And that is really a statement to you that your college education should be free from discrimination, discriminatory harassment, gender-based harassment, sexual harassment, and any retaliation in the event that something were to come up related to sexual harassment or sexual violence. You should be able to come forward and talk about things without fear of retaliation. Go ahead to the next slide, please. So Title IX, I am sure that over the last few years, all of you, or most of you at least, are familiar with the term Title IX. And essentially the bottom line on Title IX is there should be no sex discrimination, no sexual assault or harassment, period. And that is related, initially Title IX was passed to make equal opportunity for women in sports, in college sports in particular. So if, you know, a college was putting forward $100,000 a year for men's sports, they needed to do the same thing for women's. So now this has really moved to what I think is very modern times, which is that there should be no discrimination based on sex or gender identification, period. So go ahead to the next slide, please. So we have multiple points of contact for you on campus if something were to come up. So if something happens, say something to someone who can help and do something about it. Our affirmative action and Title IX coordinator is Joan Murphy, and she is also our director of human resources. She can be contacted by phone or email. And she is the person who would follow through on any formal complaints related to any of these issues. There are two people on our campus who are officially what are called confidential employees, meaning what you share with them is truly held in confidence unless they have a concern for your safety or the safety of someone else. And those two people are Kathleen Keough, our counselor who you heard from earlier, and our chief of campus police, Alex Wiltz. And I know sometimes it sounds like chief of police, that's really scary, but I wanna also tell you that our chief of police also has a counseling background and is working on his doctorate in student development and student affairs. So these are people who can help you get connected if you need assistance, and they can keep it private. The other people you can come to, but we're not bound by the same level of confidentiality, would be myself as the Dean of Students. Either of the Women's Resource Center staff, Diana Abbott or Rosemary Freeland, and then also our coordinator of disability services, Colleen Caffrey. Go ahead and go to the next slide, please. So I like to wrap it all up in these really simple terms and with the help of the Simpsons, and that is, don't be a jerk. And if someone is a jerk to you, say something. Is that it for those, Tamitha? Yeah. So public.
I can do public safety if you want.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay. So public safety. So it's the only one that we actually have a map of where it is, because in case you need to go to campus. So public safety is on the south side of the main building on the first floor. It's over here. There isn't any real reason that I would think you would probably need to make an emergency call to our public safety office. Like if you're having an emergency, obviously you want to reach out to your actual local police department. That's the word I was looking for. But here is the emergency number right here. For non-emergency, so if you need to reach public safety for some reason this semester, then you want to call them at 413-775-1212. Something you do want to make sure that you do is update your, make sure your information is all up to date in the Alert GCC database. This is an opt-out program, not an opt-in. So you are already signed up for it. So you want to make sure that if there are any security or safety alerts that go out, that they are coming to you, to whatever your current cell phone number or, you know, other phone number or, and your not, you know, your non-GCC email address that you actually check. You can also add, like, if you want like a partner or a parent to like get these security alerts, you can also sign them up as well. And then you do that by updating your information by going to my GCC, clicking on my account, and here where it says alert, Alert GCC update information. And then just so you know, that's not how you get notified about snow days. We are, even though we are remote, still having snow days. It's kind of like, you know, it's bad, you know, it's not as ideal as possible that we are remote, but here you can still have a snow day. So those you'll find out about via your email. There'll be a banner on the GCC webpage. and there's also a storm line. Really quickly, some public safety features that are on campus. There are call boxes located throughout campus that you can use to communicate with public safety. In every room, there is this Greenfield Community College Emergency Guide. There's also a copy of this in your orientation packet. And then in some main areas, there are these alert, oops, didn't mean to do that, alertist beacons, which like flash and have directions on them. But I'm not spending a lot of time on that because we're not on campus right now. And now, my friends, this is the last slide. And then we're going to do the survey, and the survey is short, and then you'll be all set and free to go. So Anna mentioned Diana Abath a couple times, who is the Women's Resource Center advocate. Peggy and I happen to be lucky enough that our offices are right across from hers, and she has this collection of stones with words on them. And during the 2 years that we were together on campus, three times she walked into my office and was like, pick a stone. And these are the three stones that I picked over those 2 years. when I went back to campus for the first time in May, those three stones were sitting on my desk still. And I, you know, they just spoke to me so strongly. I actually brought the strength stone home with me to give me the strength to make it through this pandemic. So far, so good. But I left the Believe and the Love stones at GCC because I'm, you know, the belief is there because I believe we are all going to get back there, and GCC will continue on. And love really represents the fabulous people at GCC. And so last summer I was telling the orientation leaders about these stones. I may have cried because it's just so symbolic for me. But what I want you to take away from this is, and this kind of really goes back to the tomato plant, is, you know, believe in yourself. Remember that asking for help is a sign of strength, and that GCC truly cares about you and wants you to be successful. All right, here we go. So if you, I'm sure you all logged into Moodle at the beginning to get to the webinar. Like me, your login to Moodle will have timed out, so you're going to need to log back in and get to the orientation course. When you get here, under step, so a couple of things I want to point out. One, this is the orientation packet link that I've been talking about so much, but also, just to make things easy, I threw a copy of just the Student Support Services and Resources quick link sheet just all by itself right here at the bottom, so you can find it there as well. So when you're in Moodle, you will see step three now has a link under it for the spring 2021 orientation survey. You want to click on this link, and then obviously you want to click on the screen button that says answer the questions. When you get here, you'll see this truly is a short survey. We have a couple of questions here kind of rating your experience. I really want to stress one is agree, five is disagree. I've definitely noticed that some responses, it's clear that people have mixed that up. So one is positive, five not so positive. We want to know what you found, what was most valuable about today's program, what wasn't as valuable, and just like, and we know that some of these things are more helpful to some students than other students. Just so, you know, if there's something that we talked about that you didn't think was too helpful, somebody else has put that as the thing that they thought was most valuable. What is really also very helpful for us to know, but it's not a required question, is there something that wasn't covered in orientation that you really wish we had hoped that was covered? And then these last two questions I want to talk to you a little bit about. So we are going to be, the orientation leaders are going to be doing outreach to students after orientation. and so we're looking at a couple of ways of doing that. One is via email, but we need your permission to give your only your GCC email address to share that with the orientation leaders. They will only use it for outreach. They won't use it for anything else. But we, like I said, we need your permission. We can't otherwise share GCC email addresses with fellow students. The other thing is, if you'd like to receive outreach via text message, we're, you know, hopefully getting a Google Voice account soon. And so you can just, if you are interested in also getting text messages, you can just pop your phone number in this questions bar here. And then most important, make sure you hit submit questionnaire.